Let's try to solve one example here. X squared d square y dx squared minus with 3x dy over dx plus with 3y equal to 4x to the power of 7. Okay, so if you see here, we have a second order differential equation with a variable coefficient. Therefore, we call this one as a Euler equation. And to solve Euler equation, we need to change it or transform it into a general form of second order ordinary differential equation. Therefore, to transform it, we need to know what is the value of A, B, and C. So you can see here, our value of A is equal to 1, our value of B is equal to negative 3, and the value of C is equal to 3. Okay, so now to transform into a general form of second order ODE, we need a times with d square y dt square. So we have 1 times d square y dt square plus with b minus a. So we have our b negative 3 minus with a equal to 1 dy dt plus with cy. So we have 3y equal to, don't forget that in the right hand side you need to substitute all x with exponent t. Therefore we have 4 exponent t power of 7 here. Okay, so we have now d square y dt square minus 4 dy over dt plus with 3y equal to 4 exponent 7 t. Okay, so this one is our non-homogeneous second order differential equation in a general form, where our coefficient now is a constant coefficient. So let's solve this differential equation by finding first what is yc. So we take all the left hand side, d square y dt square minus 4 dy over dt plus with 3y and make it equal to 0 for homogeneous equation. Okay, so transform it into characteristic equation. What you will get here is lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 3 is equal to 0. Okay, so we want to check the case for our quadratic equation. So we have our a is equal to 1, b equal to negative 4, and c is equal to 3. Therefore, we calculate 4b square minus 4ac here is equal to negative 4 minus with 4 times 1 times 3. So you will have 16 minus with 12 equal to 4, where 4 is greater than 0. Therefore, this case falls in the first case, which is we have two distinct real root where lambda 1 is not equal to lambda 2. So you can calculate by using calculator or factorize it manually. You will get the value of lambda 1 is equal to 3 and the value of lambda 2 is equal to 1. Therefore, for this case, our yc is equal to a exponent 3t plus with b exponent t. Okay, so now we want to find what is yp and we want to use variation of parameter method. Therefore, we need to know what is the value of y1 and y2. Okay, and we know that we can get the value of y1 and y2 from yc, where our yc is actually a dot y1 plus b dot y2. Okay, therefore directly we can say that our value of y1 is equal to exponent 3t and the value of y2 is exponent t. Okay, next we find what is y1 prime. We will have 3 exponent 3t and y2 prime is equal to exponent t. Okay, now that we already have our y1, y1 prime, y2 and y2 prime, so we can find what is our w. Okay, by using the value of y1, y1 prime, y2 and also y2 prime. Therefore, w can be computed as exponent 3t times exponent t minus with 3 exponent 3t times with exponent t. Therefore, what you will have here is exponent 4t minus 3 exponent 4t equal to negative 2 exponent 4t. So this one is our w. Next, what you need to find is to find what is the value of u. So we know that our value of u can be found by using formula negative integral y2 dot f t divided by a times w dt. Okay, therefore, we just need to substitute our y2. So our y2 is equal to exponent t times with ft. So here is our ft for exponent 7t. Divide by a times w, so our a is equal to 1, times with w, negative 2 exponent 40, so we have negative 2 exponent 40 dt. Okay, let's simplify this fraction first. So we have negative and negative become positive, so we have integrate 4 exponent 8t divided by 2 exponent 40 dt, so you will have the integration of 2 exponent 40 dt equal to 2 exponent 40 over 4 plus c. So your u is exponent 40 over 2 plus c. Now let's move to find the value of v, where v can be found by using the formula of integration of y1 dot ft times with a dot w dt. Okay, so our y1 is equal to exponent 3t. So we have the integral of exponent 3t times with our ft is 4 exponent 7t divided by a times w negative 2 exponent 40 dt. Then we simplify this fraction, we will have 4 exponent 10t divided by negative 2 exponent 40 dt. So you need to integrate negative 2 exponent 60 dt. Therefore, you will have negative 2 exponent 60 over 6 dt. Then you will have negative exponent 60 over 3. Plus d. Okay guys, we already have our value of u and v. Now we can find what is our yp. Okay, so yp is equal to u dot y1 plus with v dot y2. Therefore our u just now is exponent 40 over 2 plus c times with y1 exponent 3t plus with our v is negative exponent 60 over 3 plus d times with y2 exponent t. Okay, therefore we have our equation as exponent 70 over 2 plus c exponent 3t minus with exponent 60 over 3 plus d exponent t. Okay, here we should have exponent 70, sorry. Alright, so now, this is our yp. We can already find what is our y, where
now
y...
Now let's find what is the value of y, where y is equal to yc plus yp.
Okay, so... we already have our yc here is equal to a exponent 3t plus b exponent t. So we have a exponent 3t plus b exponent t plus with yp, everything here. So we have exponent 70 over 2 plus c exponent 3t minus exponent 70 over 3 plus d exponent.
Okay, so we can collect the same term, where here we have exponent 3t with exponent 3t, exponent t and exponent t. Okay, therefore what you will have here is a plus c exponent 3t plus with b plus d exponent t plus with exponent 70 over 2 minus with exponent 70 over 3.
We
you see here, this one can be simplified, where this one is 1 over 2 exponent 70 minus with 1 over 3 exponent 70. So you will get 1 over 6 exponent 70. So let's rewrite this y. So we have y equal to a plus c exponent 3t plus with b plus d exponent t plus with 1 over 6 exponent 70. Okay. Don't forget that we need our answer y in term of x. Just now we have been used a substitution where x have been substituted with exponent t. Therefore, if we want t, we need to plus ln for both sides. So ln and exponent can be cancelled out. Therefore, we have ln x equal to t. Okay, so now we need to substitute all t with ln x. So what you will have here is a plus c exponent 3 ln x plus with b plus d exponent ln x plus with 1 over 6 exponent 7 ln x. Okay, now I will bring the power or the coefficient in front here to the back as a power. Okay, therefore what I will have here is a plus c exponent ln x to the power of 3 plus with b plus d exponent ln x plus with 1 over 6 exponent ln x to the power of 7. Okay, so now you know that exponent and ln can be eliminated. Okay, so what you left with as an answer or as a solution to your differential equation is a plus c x to the power of 3 plus b plus d x plus with 1 over 6 x to the power of 7. So this is the solution to your differential equation.